There are many reasons why musicals are still relevant.
I think anybody can at any time sit in any musical and be entertained, follow the story and join the music.
It's entertaining. It gets you out of your casual or daily problems.
It's a combination of everything. You need to dance, you need to act, you need to sing. You need to convince the people that you're doing this role, and this role is convincing. And I think therefore your musical theater is the ideal art of theater.
I really like the way we went through the whole set list of the Broadway album.
I think it was something that we were thinking many years ago. Obviously, because when you do so many pop songs, suddenly we thought that we should do something for a special event. So therefore we just thought, let's do like a concept album so we can show the people that Olivo is not only just four singers who can scream sometimes.
The idea for the album, that was an easy one. That was kind of a no-brainer. It was like, you know, we should do an album of music theater. That's a great idea. Let's do that. And then we got into it and it was like, oh, okay, well, this is going to be a lot of work.
We tried many, many musical theater songs in our last shows, like Don't Cry from Argentina, The Impossible Dream, Somewhere. And you see how you connect with the audience every time you sing that.
It was a real partnership with our record company and management, and a real desire to make the best album.
Trying to figure out from the wealth of material that music theater has to offer, trying to narrow that down was quite difficult.
So we had to kind of figure out what works best, or how do we make the different styles work in our voices, in our configuration.
For us, this time around, going back to Belgium, was a very unique process, because that was the first time we could work with a new producer.
Our new producer on this record, Alberto Quintero, is an old friend of Carlos, actually. He's known us for many, many years. He's been to many shows that we've performed.
It was a great experience for us to work someone fresh who's never worked with us before.
He really helped us negotiate our voices into this repertoire, because it can be very specific.
He's a guy who just mixes himself, he does the arrangement, and he does everything. So he's just fantastic. He's a very, and he was also one of the biggest conductors in Spain doing all the musicals. So therefore we thought he would be the best one to do this kind of album.
He's a musician with heart and soul as well. He loves what he's doing. He does it for 15 hours a day, and he's not getting tired. And it was just a very, very nice experience working with him. I've had met Michael Ball a couple of times before, but only very briefly, you know, maybe on the red carpet where you say hi and bye and how are you and what you're doing. Yeah, great, good luck.
I'm a big fan of Michael Ball, and then when we met Michael the first time and he came to us, hey guys, we should sing something together.
Michael Ball is just a master.
He is such a wonderful person. I mean, he's so much fun.
He was in the morning show here in London, and he was invited because he was releasing his album, and then he came to us and said, we should sing something. Let's do, why we don't do Love Changes Everything. So we went to the studio, we just did it. We just went there. It was practically improvised. We just divided the song with him, and he was there at the studio recording with us.
And he basically pulled it all together and sat as producer in the booth, listening to the four of us, and obviously he knew what he was going to do.
It was a fantastic experience, and then we sang for the Queen, in front of the Queen, with him, the song for the first time.
He's such a tremendous singer and such a tremendous guy, and so much fun to work with.
He's just hilarious to work with.
Great, great fun making music together.
Heather Headley, she is just exceptional.
She is a phenomenal performer, phenomenal actress, phenomenal voice.
So it's a great, great honor and a chance for us to get her to agree to sing with us. She was in the original production, in the Broadway production of The Lion King.
Everyone knows The Lion King, and Heather has such a beautiful voice.
You know, I remember hearing them when they first came out, and I just thought they're so good. The harmonies were so tight. The voices individually were amazing, and then collectively together was just this beautiful, you know, unison. Like you just know. I was actually talking to somebody the other day. I was reminded that my choir director used to say, "The sign of a great singer is one who can sing with other singers and who can blend in with other singers, and who can take a solo and be amazing at it, but yet can go into a group of other singers and you don't even know that they're there." And I think that's the beauty with Il Divo. So I am very flattered that they would ask me to be a part of the project and that I can be. And I think it will be fun. I'm excited about it. The
hours go so slowly. Rehearsals are somewhat strange, you know, because I think the guys come over as being very cool and collected about it, and secretly I think they're incredibly nervous about it. It's new stuff, it's interesting, it'll be a challenge.
That's very exciting. Really exciting, but you know, yeah, there's still a lot of work to be done.
I've been working with them now for just over 2 years, and looking very forward to being on Broadway, doing the styling for the show. This is my first day of rehearsals, actually, so it'll be nice to see how it's panning out. It's nice to see the set. The set looks really amazing. It should go smoothly, let's hope.
They were really fun. This is my first time working with them, and I'm hoping they're having a good time, because I am. There's so many departments and things that we've been working on in our set design and the lighting and the blocking. I'm looking forward to seeing it come together and see how it all radiates.
About to start on Broadway, you know, going into the Marquee Theater and releasing the album. I mean, it's a huge week for us. So trying to conserve the energy, trying to contain the excitement, save it for opening night.
Hi, everyone. It's a real pleasure to say that we're really happy to start with this amazing tour. It's going to be really beautiful here on Broadway. It's going to be a big honor.
And then we obviously next year going to take this whole show around the world on tour. So we can't wait to come to your city and show you our new repertoire, our new show, our brand new achievements. Hope you love it. See you then.